Dear friends and family, we're gathered here today to witness the union of Matt and Kate as husband and wife. Marriage is not a man-made union, but one established by God. In Genesis 2, 22 through 24, after God created man, he declared that it was not good for the man to be alone. So he took one of Adam's ribs and created Eve and presented her to Adam and declared them to be joined together as one. Genesis 2:24 tells us, "Therefore a man shall leave his father and his mother and hold fast to his wife, and they shall become one flesh." This union that we see here today is something that is not established by man, but by God, as he is the one that created it. Not only did he establish and create the institution of marriage, but God in his infinite love and wisdom towards us did not leave us to our own devices as to how it should work, but gave us clear instructions in his word as to how marriage is to function. In Ephesians 5:21 through 33, God's word tells us, "Submit to one another out of reverence for Christ. Wives, submit to your own husbands as to the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church, his body, and is himself its Savior. Now as the church submits to Christ, so also wives should submit in everything to their husbands. Husbands, love your wives as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her, that he might sanctify her, having cleansed her by the washing of water with the word, so that he might present the church to himself in splendor without spot or wrinkle or any such thing, that she might be holy and without blemish. In the same way, husbands should love their wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself. For no one ever hated his own flesh, but nourishes and cherishes it, just as Christ does the church, because we are members of his body. Therefore, a man shall leave his father and mother and hold fast to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. This mystery is profound, and I'm saying that it refers to Christ and the church. However, let each and every one of you love his wife as himself, and let the wife see that she respects her husband. So again, in God's infinite love and wisdom, he gives us instructions as to how marriage is to work and how you're to love one another. And just as Christ also promises to never leave us or forsake us, your vows are your promises to each other, before God in heaven and before these witnesses here today. Matt, what are your vows to Kate?
All right. You've witnessed all of my faults. You've seen me at my worst. You've watched stubbornness get the best of me and my foolishness embarrass me. I guess instead of using the words witnessed, seen, and watched, I should say that you've allowed me to be this mess of a man. Through a friendship that by God's grace trickled into a relationship, you have remained dedicated to supporting me and standing by me. And now here you are, standing before God, family, and friends, taking a vow of commitment to become one flesh. I will forever show my gratitude as long as I shall live to you through the little things that I do and by loving you as I love myself, and to God through prayer and worship. I promise to continue growing with you spiritually and to keep God at the center of our union, for this is my duty as a spiritual leader of our home. Through each and every trial that we face as a family, I have the utmost faith that we will always come out better than we were, for I know God has prepared our hearts for one another. Lastly, I promise to continue being what we always were. I promise to be your friend. I promise to be your confidant. Mary Catherine, I was never so proud of my last name until the day that I realized I got to give it away to you.
And now I have to talk. James Matthew Cozard, you are my best friend. Today and forever.
I got you. You good?
Too close.
That's all I got.
I am inspired daily by the man you are. Your heart, your soul, every bit of it. I promise to always believe in you and trust you completely. To respect and honor you as the head of this family and support your decisions, I'll always have your back. I promise to always be honest with you, even when it means being vulnerable. I promise to stand by you on our best days and hold on to you on our worst. I promise to always keep God first and center our marriage on him, because we are capable of nothing by ourselves. I promise to not just feel love for you, but to practice love, to walk in love, freely giving all of myself to you every day. Agapemu kaizuemu.
Attaboy.
All of my love and all of my life I give to you. My husband, my partner. There's no greater blessing on earth than to take the name of my best friend.
That was not planned.
Go Cubbies.
Roll Tide. And y'all made it. Thank you. I'm so sorry. I'm glad. I love y'all. I'm sorry.
Just as you've exchanged these vows, let us now exchange the rings. Matt, if you would, take Kate's ring and repeat after me. Kate, with this ring, I take you as my wife from this day forward.
Kate, with this ring, I take you as my wife from this day forward. Oh, that was it. You need the sand. There you go.
And then the ring.
All right.
You have it. Great. Awesome. All right. And Kate, if you would, take Matt's ring and repeat after me. Matt, with this ring, I take you as my husband from this day forward.
Matt, with this ring, I take you as my husband from this day forward.
I now pronounce you husband and wife.
What?
You may now kiss your bride. Dear friends and family, as you've witnessed the union of these two, I now charge you to pray for them regularly, to encourage them, to love them, and to make every effort to support them in this union. For what God has brought together, let no man separate. If you, as friends and family, accept this charge, please say, I will.
I will.
Thank you, Annie.
Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for bringing Matt and Kate together. We thank you, Lord, for your love for each and every one of them, for each of them. And I just pray that as you've brought them together, it is only you and you alone, Lord, that can help them to continue to grow in their love for one another and in their love for you. Bless their union. As I pray these things in Jesus' name, amen. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my privilege to introduce you to Mr. and Mrs. Matt Cozart.